Hey guys, this is Stu, and I'm here to give you an overview of what's new in Colorista 2. Colorista 2 is the evolution of Colorista, if you're familiar with it. It's a three-way color corrector that we designed at Red Giant to be compatible with all your favorite apps and consistent across them. And Colorista 2, at first glance, are the primary feature is the three-way color corrector itself. Shadow, midtones, and highlights, each with their own color wheel. We've revamped the look and functionality of this a little bit. You'll notice, for instance, that if I were to say cool off the midtones of this image here, I have some extra ways that I can adjust that control. I can adjust just the puck around the outside, and then I can also increase or decrease just the saturation of this adjustment by scrubbing this slider that appears on the color swatch, in addition to being able to raise or lower the brightness. Really nice. We've also changed the what used to be the white balance tool is now an auto balance tool. So when you use it to sample something in your scene that is white or gray, it not only changes the highlight color to balance out the shot in your own kind of film transfer curve for your shot, but you can go in and adjust them on a red, green, blue basis. So let's talk about the obvious one that we haven't talked about yet, which is this new HSL control here. The HSL control is designed the color of that blue by just grabbing the blue dot in HSL. And for instance, if I move the blue dot closer to the cyan dot, I'm changing her sweater color from blue to a sort of turquoise color. Again, I can double click on the dot to reset it, and now I can move the blue dot towards purple, and I can start turning her sweater more purple. I can also push it towards the center of the control pot, and as I do that, I'm desaturating blue. And you can see a visual confirmation of this. First of all, the blue dot in this hue and saturation wheel here, the center of the wheel is less saturated. So if I push the blue dot towards the less saturated color, then I get a less saturated color. Similarly, if I push the blue dot toward cyan, I get a more cyan color for blue. And I can do combinations of these. I can also pull the dot away from the lower saturation area. And as you might expect, in doing so, I create a super saturated blue color for her sweater. And then over here where we have the hue and lightness wheel, you might be able to anticipate what's going to happen here. I can make blue darker by pushing it in towards the center. The handy thing here is that we don't just have Mojo, which is show skin overlay. If I turn that on, and I'll just zoom in on her here, you can see that her skin tones have a orange grid. What I want to do is use all of these tools together to color correct this shot. So I will use auto balance on this one. I know that this box is white here, and I'm just going to click on it to sample it, do a quickie balance for the shot overall. Then I'm actually going to get rid of primary and open up master. What I'm going to do now is dial in a look for the shot. And I like to dial in the look in master, and in a future tutorial, I'll explain why here. So we're going to just starter for colors in the shot to be anything other than this sort of bluish cyan. And if you want to see the effect of that turned on and off, there's a bypass control here for master. I can turn it off. You see the entire master control area gets ghosted to show that it's bypassed, and turn it back on. You can see this is a handy way of your eye and making you look at that text. Now, I can't fix the text with color correction, but maybe I can fix that bright yellow color. So let's go to a frame where we can see a lot of that box. And now I'm going to take some time with this here because things, but by default, you have a marquee select tool active. And for the most part, this is always going to be a great way to start. I'm just going to drag out a selection of the yellow in the box here. And as you can see, I'm just sort of scrubbing on the box to accumulate more of a key here. And that is adjusting for me all of the surrounding scrub and increase that key to try to fill in those other areas. Now, of course, the problem with edges and the reason so many people don't take their color correction demos all the way to fixing the edges is that controls, I can effectively choke the correction. So I'm just going to clip in with the whites here. May have made it just a little too soft. Clip in with the white. It was secondary. All right. So that's about what I'm comfortable with doing. And I'm just going to scrub through my animation of the shot. So let's look at the before and the after. Now, the last thing I want to do to the shot to make it really sing is add a little bit of a vignette. The truth is, I've kind of run out of controls. As deep as Colorista 2 is, it only has one secondary. But if you remember from Colorista 1, the coolest two, here's the original. Here it is corrected. And one of the things about Colorista 2 is that it works entirely on your GPU, so the render time is, or some of the tricks of kind of increasing local contrast in a shot, pop is like that. And if I just start to slowly increase pop, what you'll see is that I start to just give the shot a little bit more pop. Here it is without, and here it is with. It's emphasizing her beautiful wrinkled face. It's emphasizing all the grungy boxes and all the kind of funky activity of the background of the shot. It's really kind of cool.